Hi viewers, welcome to LMS Solution. Today we are going to see about Model Predictive Control of Pmsm. So this is a Simulink model we developed for Model Predictive Control of Pmsm. And here you can see that we used the DC source voltage is 500 volt, and then it going to be converted into AC by using this inverter, 3 phase inverter, voltage source inverter. And here we are using PMSM with rating of 0.8 Newton meter, 300 volt, 3000 RPM PMSM. And these are the main stator phase resistance, armature inductance, and the flux linkage of the permanent magnet synchronous motor. And also here you can see the number of volt pair equal to 2. So from that PMSM you need to measure the different parameter. So first you have to measure rotor angle, and the next you have to measure stator current, next you have to measure rotor speed, next you have to measure electromagnetic torque. Okay, so first you have to measure the rotor angle, and rotor angle in the form of mechanical degree, so that should be converted into electrical degree. So that means you have to multiply it with P divided by 2. Okay, so here number of pole pair equal to 2, so number of poles equal to 4, so 4 by 2 which is equal to 2. Okay, and then here we are converting the ABC, that means stator current, 3 phase current into 2 phase current, that means by using a power transformation ABC to DQ naught. Okay, and then here we are measuring the speed of the machine, and it going to be converted into per unit, and then the same speed, or that means the speed in the radian per second when we combined with reference speed. So here we are using reference speed command is 100 radian per second. After 0.05 second, it's going to be changed to 125 radian per second, and it's going to be processed by PA controller. So this controller will be generate the IQ reference. So here we are doing ID reference equal to 0, because here we are using, we are applying field oriented control, so that's the way we are making ID reference equal to 0. And then we have clock input, and then you have to provide electrical rotor angle. Okay, so these are the input for the MP, model predictive control, that means speed reference, ID, actual ID and IQ, IQ reference, ID reference, clock input, and then theta in electrical degree. So these are the input for the model predictive control. So inside model predictive control, so again you got to initialize the value of the PMSM inductance, stator resistance, and then flux linkage, and then you have to specify that voltage 500, okay, DC voltage. And any then mean this is the sector we are having, that mean there are 8 sector. So you have to calculate ID and IQ, that means you have to predict the ID IQ, so based upon this 8 sector. And then initially we have to fix the cost function, so here we need to minimize the cost function, right? We need to predict the switching pulse for that voltage source inverter, not to control the PMSM. Okay, so here we have 8 switching cost function, that means you have to use cost function. So it contain 8 × 1 matrix, and then initial pulse we are consider, that means 0 0 0 0, that means S1 to S6 pulse here we are mentioning at 0. And then you have to use for loop in order to calculate the cost for the different pattern, switching pattern. Okay, so here we have 8 switching pattern, so each switching pattern will be passes through this calculation of voltage of the inverter. From that you have to calculate VSQ and VST, and then you have to calculate ID and the IQ prediction value. So from that ID IQ prediction value you have to find out the cost function based upon the ID IQ prediction and ID reference IQ reference. Okay, so this is the cost function used for model predictive control. So after calculating cost function, you have to short that cost function, that means minimum to maximum, right? So based upon minimum to maximum shorting, right, you have to send the pulse. Okay, so now we can see that. So this pulse we are going to send to that voltage source inverter based upon that cost function. So here you are going to check index, right? Index means so we have 8 state, right? In 8 state, some of state having minimum value of cost function, right? So you have to find out that exact position, right? So that is known as index. So we are checking the index. The index 1,1, which is equal to 1. That means whether it is equal to 1 or not, okay? If it is equal to 1, you have to send this pulse. Otherwise, you have to check for next, okay? So we have to check the index based upon that cost function. And then you have to send the pulse for that voltage source inverter. So that voltage source inverter going to be control that PMSM in order to control the speed of the machine or torque of the machine. Okay. So here we are going to predict the value of ID and the IQ. So based upon that you have to calculate the cost function for model predictive control. So based upon cost function, we are going to control that voltage source inverter in order to control the PMSM. So after that it will be generate the pulse. This pulse going to be given to this voltage source inverter, it will be controlled this PMSM. So here we have different kind of scopes. So here we are measuring the voltage, right? Voltage of the voltage source inverter, that means output side, right? And then this is a stator current of the PMSM, and here we are measuring reference speed and actual speed of the PMSM, and here we are measuring electromagnetic torque of the PMSM, and then here we are measuring that the pulse for that voltage source inverter. So here already explained it, that means the reference speed here we fixed at 180 per second from 0 to 0.5 seconds. After 0.05 seconds, the reference speed change to 125 radian per second. So let me simulate the model. We have to check the results. So next I am going to simulate this model. So here you can see that. So the reference speed here fixed at 100. And then this actual speed is settled at before 0.02 seconds, right? And also here this is known as the voltage of the inverter, right? And then this is a stator current of the PMSM, okay? And then here you can see this is the electromagnetic torque. So initially here you can see that the torque of the machine is maintained at 0.3 newton meter up to 0.05 second. After 0.05 seconds, so we change to 0.6 newton meter, because the maximum torque condition, that means maximum load condition, is 0.8 newton meter, right? That means rated condition. So that's why we are using 0.3 newton meter to 0.6 newton meter. So here you can see that initially the that means during starting it goes to around 3.2 newton meter, and then it comes to 0.3 newton meter, because the load torque here we are maintaining at 0.3 newton meter. And also this is a corresponding current, right? So here also you can see that the current almost maintained at 0.3, I think 0.5 amps peak, okay? And then here after 0.5 second, after 0.05 seconds, the torque changed from 0.3 newton meter to 0.6. So here you can see that The electromagnetic torque is maintained at around 0.6 Newton meter, and also you can see this the corresponding change, because the load is increased in the PMSM. So because of the what happened, that stator current also increased around 1.2 amps peak. Okay, and then here you can see this. So this is a change in speed with respect to change in reference current. Okay, so initially the speed is, reference speed is 100 radian per second. So that's why actual speed is maintained around 100 radian per second. After 0.05 seconds, the reference speed changed from 100 to 125 radian per second. So that's why this PMSM speed is changed from 100 to around 125 radian per seconds, right? So here both speed as well as torque going to be controlled in the system. So based upon this model predictive control. So this is the working of this model. Thanks for watching our videos. Kindly subscribe our channel and also click bell icon for notification about upcoming videos. Thank you. Thank you so much. Bye bye.